Welcome to another episode of CircuitBread Practicals, where we talk about that intersection between electrical work and electrical engineering and trying to make it so as electrical engineers, we aren't quite so embarrassing ourselves when somebody asks us to do any sort of work or at least gives some advice on what's going on in an electrical system in a house. So today we are going to talk about how to wire up a 240-volt circuit. Now this is really, really simple and not that common, but I thought it'd be good to go over. So most of the time when you're working in any residential or commercial applications, you have your outlets, you have your lights, everything works at 120, at least here in the United States. But every once in a while you get a 240-volt piece of equipment that's necessary. Either that's a really large power supply in your lab, or it's a piece of woodworking equipment, or it's your air conditioner condenser, or your hot water heater, something like that. So what you do is you have your panel, and this is the panel that we have in our shed, and you can see over here the 120-volt lines, and these are pretty straightforward because they only have one place and you just plug in this hot 120 volt out to whatever. I'd have to look at what this is. This is either lights or an outlet, and that's quite straightforward. Now with the 240 volt, it's actually just as straightforward. Now with these two, and I want to clarify that this is a dead panel, so nothing, if you're working on this, don't fry yourself, turn off all the electricity. But if you look at this, you've got your two incoming power lines. And the way they come down is they separate. So you have, if you look at this one versus this one, this circuit breaker is actually attached to this line as the hot, and this circuit breaker is actually attached to this line as hot. Now what happens is if you have something like this, this is our 240 volt 50 amp, this is for RVs, we have an RV plug, so if somebody comes and visits us, they can just back up to the shed and plug in and be good to go. This one is actually touching both of them. And so now you're getting that out of phase, that 90 degree out of phase, 240 volts, because as this one peaks high, this one peaks low. So even though it's up 120, that's down 120 and you get your 240 volts. Now, most of the time when you're doing wiring, if you're dealing with like 12-2, 10-2, 14-2, all of those things like we discussed in our ampacity video, you only have your two conductors. You have your black and your white. However, this, since this is THHN, you just run an extra wire. Now, the electrician that ran this obviously just had a lot of black wire, so instead of running a separate red wire, he took a black wire and wrapped it up with red tape. But if you have the time, the ability, or whatever, you can get a red wire. Now, when you are dealing with AC systems, black wire is hot, white wire is neutral, green or bare wire is ground, that safety ground. And then red wire is typically your other hot leg, but it can also be something else. It can be a communication line. It could be something else. It's more of an other category. But in this case, it gives us that second hot line. So if you have a 240 volt system that you need, you have to have a double breaker like this that can tag onto both of these lines. And then you put black into one and red into the other and then run it to where you need to go. Now, if you have a 240 volt outlet that doesn't need neutral, then you'll only run these two in ground. But a lot of times, like on a dryer, it'll be black, red, neutral, and ground. And so you'll need to run four wires, three conductors, one ground wire, to your device. And that's really it. You need to make sure you have the right circuit breaker. If you have one that only has one spot like this, it's not gonna work for your 240 volts. You're gonna need something like this that accesses both sides of the power coming in so that you can get it to your source. So that's it. I mean, I'm not sure exactly how exciting that was. Hopefully that helps you. If you have any questions, you're like, oh my goodness, I have something that needs 240 volts. How do I even do it? That's really it. You can go and you can get 240 volt circuit breakers. The two pole, I think is what they call them. 50 amps, 40 amps, 30 amps, 20 amps. I don't think I've seen 15 amps, but you can get them of varying sizes. And frankly, I'm hoping to get a dust removal system in here. And so I'll probably have to get a 20 amp 240 volt system in this box eventually when I get around to it. So hopefully that was helpful. Hopefully that helped you understand exactly what's going on in these boxes and make it so you can set up a 240 volt system in your house or your shed or whatever. If you're not sure, if you're not confident, if you think, oh my gosh, I might blow something up, please don't call an electrician. Don't hurt yourself, but hopefully this will at least make it so you can talk intelligently to the electrician and know what they are going to do. If you liked this video, give it a like, subscribe to our channel. Please join us as we very soon go back to our electrical engineering topics about circuits, control systems, embedded systems, and all that very, very fun stuff. And we get away from this practical yet very, very useful stuff. All right, hope you liked it. Have a great one. Hey, we hope you enjoyed this video. Did you know that CircuitBread.com does more than just tutorials? Besides tools, textbooks, and other things, we host an ever-growing library of math and electronics-related equations and glossary terms. Don't have the entire table of integrals or Faraday's second law memorized? We gotcha. Go check them all out.